So many of you wanted a tour of my studio and a little bit behind the scenes. So here it is. This is where we do the TW3 podcast every Monday night at 9 p.m. Over on your right there, you'll see where my two panel guests that are on camera will sit. And then right over off camera, the producer normally, which is River, will sit and he also monitor the chat and what's going on there. And then we come over here. Of course, I've got for lighting and stuff, I have a back panel there and some acoustic paneling there and the wood furnishing. And of course, I'm using my MacBook Pro to stream with. And when I look out, of course, I'm always seeing people come in. It's amazing with these compressor limiters and gates and everything, people can walk in and see it right there. You see the rack that's to the left. When I sit down, it's right to the left of my feet. And what you're looking at there is two PreSonus tube preamps, Studio Pre's, four DBX286S's, and three Livewire power distributions. And they've all been replaced by this one unit right here. This thing, this Rode Rodecaster Pro, has replaced a whole rack of $4,000 and $5,000 worth of studio gear all in one unit. It gives me the power of everything that rack of preamps and tube pre's did. It does it all at the touch of a screen. You don't have to be, you know, some techno genius, engineering genius to be able to run this thing. It comes with the Aphex Oral Exciter already equipped. I am running the updated software that's still not been released yet. It's still in beta. Of course, when this video comes out later on, you probably, it's going to even have more advanced than this, but you can go in and you can fine tune on a micro level, you know, your gates, your thresholds, everything. What you're hearing right now is me talking and recording this audio through that using a Heil PR40 microphone, dynamic microphone. But it is so simplistic. I am just amazed at how simplistic this is. It replaced a Yamaha 16 channel mixer. What you see over there is all of my intros, outros, jingles, everything I need is right there, and then a separate slider. Of course, I have the Stream Deck right here because I use OBS to do all my streaming, and I've got this sync there. And so all my intros, my outros, interviews I'm doing, switching cameras, going back and forth between me and my panel, and the commercials I use, everything. It's like an advanced video switcher, but it does more than just video switching. It will fly in files that I need right there on a fly. It will allow me to have a screen in screen to show, you know, if I'm illustrating something with my computer. Very powerful. But I am amazed that the way this Rodecaster has replaced that entire rack that you saw. It's absolutely amazing. And so keep in mind, this podcast started with just a MacBook, Apple book years ago, back in 2009, 2010, somewhere in that area, where we started this in a walk-in closet on a card table. And through this, we've been able to build a business and have a house built for us and have one room dedicated right when you walk in the first front of our home. What would typically be, you know, just an office, we've sort of converted into our podcast studio. And that's where every Monday night we're able to equip people, hopefully inspire them, give them some illustrations of how they can take their business to new levels. But it all starts on a card table with just a MacBook, and then we're here. And I'm just amazed that I went from having to have a whole rack of, you know, tools to basically one unit that does everything from my jingles to my intro outros. The other thing I didn't mention was you can sync it to your phone through Bluetooth, and I can be having a phone call and talking to someone on the show through over the phone. So that's very powerful. Of course, the other slider beside channel 4 there, which would be channel 5, it's actually for audio that's coming back from the computer. And let me tell you, I don't want to get too techie here, but you know, beforehand to run what's called a mix minus, man, I had to do some, you know, wiring and running things through an aux, and it was very technical. This thing, push of a button, I say I need a mix minus, it knows what to do. Don't have to run the auxiliaries and set things up in a weird way that it's made for people that are not natural audio engineers, and it's almost foolproof to where you can get a really good sound even if you don't have, you know, the background in audio and engineering. So can't say enough about this unit. And this is the layout. This is the studio. This is how we stream. We record audio and video. And I've basically now, if I had to break it down, three major components: my computer, the Stream Deck, and the Rodecaster unit to podcast. And that's it. And it does the job, and I can't say enough. So I hope you enjoyed this little tour here. And I'll put links in the video here if you want to look at this. And then they're not affiliate links, so, you know, I don't get paid to promote Rodecaster. I just think it's a great unit. So I hope you take advantage of it.